artificial intelligence, encryption, programming language. These terms are quite frankly a little foreign to me, with me not being a national citizen of the IT kingdom. But thanks to the undeniable marrow of Gen Z, they're not exactly Greek and Latin either. So let's try to move from point A to point Z. Though time may not permit us to reach point Z, the beginning is the most important part of the work. Allow me to be completely honest. The invasion of AI into medicine is what piqued my interest, fascinated me, and lured me to this topic. But I'm sure we can all agree when I say that AI is this close to becoming omnipresent, as it is being proven to us so illustriously, even through customary YouTube ads. So let's whiz through a few before I hook, line, and tow us all to healthcare. Social media, elixir of life for some, bane of existence for others. I have a few examples that even a non-technical person should be aware of. Snapchat uses My AI, which is a generative chatbot powered by ChatGPT's technology. Twitter uses IBM Watson and natural language processing tools to filter malicious content. LinkedIn uses AI to create better job descriptions, thus enabling a wider reach. Instagram uses AI to filter spam, edit images, edit videos, and to regulate any content with hate speech, cyberbullying, and so on. Countless benefits, for sure. However, every coin has two sides. And the other side of this particular coin is AI bias. This could be a result of personal bias on the creator's part, or simply due to the lack of well-rounded information available while creating the algorithm. Deeper down, we find deep fakes, echoing of misinformation, offensive intrusion of privacy, and more. Jumping ship to tangible robots. And I'm not just talking about the trending topics, Erica and Sophia, the extremely intelligent, starkly complex, and meekly human-like robots. I'm talking about the robots doing the precise, repetitive work in manufacturing, monotonous desk and desktop jobs in e-commerce, and even mining, exploring for fuels, and any other job deemed far too dangerous for a mere human being. Let's add education to the mix, taking it all the way back to the 1980s, when MIT Labs came up with Lego Mindstorm kits to bolster up education. In the bargain, today we have smarter, interactive boards, customizable lesson plans, at the click of a few buttons. These have become so accessible, so commutable, and so easy to use that long gone are the days when kids used to come back home from school, open up their book bags, get out their homework or assignment, and actually have to sit and go through pages upon pages for the answers, or relentlessly nag parents and elder siblings for assistance. Now, I'd like us all to zero in on a printer, for example. A simple printer, a standard printer, what sets that apart from, say, an AI printer? Off of my crude understanding, an AI printer would simply be more intelligent, nay, independent, which means that I no longer need to be worried about anxiety-inducing settings like setting up the page margins and the borders and fitting the sheet onto one page and so on, because a human-like intelligence would take care of all that for me. Lesser work for me, fewer papers wasted on dummy test runs, an inflated sigh of relief from demanding bosses. Now let's take that level and quality of skill into an operation theatre, where a crucial surgery is being performed, the one that decides between life and death, the one that simply cannot afford a slip of the hand, a lapse in judgment, or even a fleeting moment of distraction. An expert system or a humanoid robot in that scenario would work wonders. Now, an expertly implemented AI system has the ability to adeptly use recorded medical data to pinpoint at-risk areas, at-risk populations, at-risk lifestyles for an infection, and control those on a humongous scale. Sounds a bit familiar, doesn't it? When the novel coronavirus invaded our lives, according to an NCBI article by Muzamil Khan and his team of researchers, copious amounts of data collected from formidable databases, including ScienceDirect, Google Scholar, and so on, coupled with dominant AI techniques like machine learning and deep learning, greatly improved the COVID-19 screening, diagnosis, response, treatment, and so on. And we all know the fairy tale ending. Now, AI in medicine exists in many forms, from the purely virtual to the cyber-physical. An example of cyber-physical would be AI nanorobots. These are to our human body's natural biomolecules what a humanoid would be to a human. According to article number 74, published in the 16th edition of the Journal of Hematology and Oncology, one of the unmet challenges of these nanorobots is introducing them effectually into real-world clinical practices. However, that same article acknowledges that in recent years, several applications of micro and nanorobots have been realized from theory to practice, from in vitro to in vivo applications. And if these trials emerge victorious, AI nanorobots would reign supreme in a variety of medical functions, precise drug delivery, targeted cell therapy, cancer treatments, and more. Performing these functions as well as, if not better, than human professionals. Now, let me illuminate this with another example. Please bear with me. Breast cancer. It has dismally become one of the most daunting obstacles of the 21st century. And the information I'm about to convey has been prudently extracted from an article published in The Curious, which is a journal of medical science. This article was penned by Dr. Gayathri and Dr. Sandeep, both of whom are integral parts of the Department of Surgery in Jawaharlal Nehru Medical College. This article reiterates that the incorporation of AI into screening tests, even examining a biopsy slide under the microscope, has greatly enhanced the treatment success rates. And I know what we're all thinking. We've come a long way without AI in terms of cancer treatment. But with AI, we can train prediction models with artificial neural networks that can be used way down in the future and that can do most of the work on its own, thus paving the way to better treatment, more effective treatment, and faster treatment. Now, I rest a little easy knowing that I've dispatched at least a diminutive dose of AI in a very diminutive portion of healthcare. But bearing in mind that there is a coin, and that coin has two sides, and here's the crucial flip side. Social and ethical conflicts regarding human security, human privacy, human rights, the meritorious patient-doctor relationship and trust that would be broken, if not obliterated, if AI was to dominate. Not to mention the severe lack of common sense, morals, empathy, compassion, all of these traits that are unique to us humans. They make us human. Some of these precious gems that we sadly forget we have in the first place. But that's a different discussion for another day. Now, I'd like to swiftly switch lanes to talk about one of these precious jewels, creativity. Creative expression through art, music, cinema, theater, and more. According to renowned psychologist Edward D. Bono, creativity involves breaking out of an established system to look at things in a different way. And folks, correct me if I'm wrong, but sticking to a set algorithm and following the given pattern down to the T is what AI does best. And as George Bernard Shaw said, we use works of art to show and look at the human soul, much like we use a mirror to see a face and interpret emotion. And I personally think truer words have never been spoken. I'm sure we all at some point have gone to the theater or the cinemas to enjoy riveting, mind-boggling, jaw-dropping, and I could go on with the adjectives, but simply amazing visuals on the big and small screens, thanks to AI. And AI has definitely opened the door to potentially seeing your favorite celebrity on the screen after an untimely, premature demise. Or maybe hear that one special voice, iconic voice, live, singing that one special song that got you through those special moments in your life, or simply gives you chills. Bear with me, I've got more examples for you. An article published in The Conversation about AI and holograms on the 1st of June, 2023, discusses the aftermath of a holographic Tupac Shakur, headlining Coachella in 2012. It also leads the readers to ponder about posthumous tours which have been proposed for other musical greats like Whitney Houston, Amy Winehouse, Michael Jackson, Prince, and more. Another article talks about a video game, DLC Phantom Liberty. This article was published in The Verge on the 13th of October, 2023. And it talks about how an AI-edited voice of a deceased actor was used to complete his role as Dr. Victor Vector in the video game. Let's take a moment to imagine. Imagine seeing timeless icons, the likes of James Dean, Marilyn Monroe, Audrey Hepburn, back on your screen today. Imagine hearing that long-awaited collab between, say, the King of Pop and the King of Rock and Roll. Imagine heading to the cinemas tomorrow to watch the next Black Panther film starring the inspirational late Chadwick Boseman. Just imagine. This article talks about fans who lauded the technical wizardry and the walk down memory lane. But it also talks about fans who left the performances feeling unsettled, a little disturbed, and even wondered how easily it is to exploit the images of the icons they love and adore. Potentially misused. And some even question the lack of authenticity. In other creative fields like writing and animation, AI has led to critical dwindling of staffing requirements, wages, duration of employment for the creators, and more. This is not just affecting an artist's passion for life, but their livelihood, as many of you may be well aware of the writer's strike in 2023 by members of the Writers Guild of America. Now, AI clearly struggles to capture the depth of human emotion and intuition that only a human artist can bring to their work. Therefore, it makes perfect sense to me to only use AI as a tool, much like a writer uses a pen or a painter uses a paintbrush, to help bring their visions to life. AI isn't going anywhere. It is here to stay, and with unlimited possibilities. But I urge you to reserve in mind that an AI tool, much like its human creator, can be flawed. AI may definitely become a necessity in critical areas, in inflexible areas like medicine and manufacturing and more. However, in less critical areas, in less technical areas where the consequences are not as severe, I feel that humans should be given the room to explore, experience, experiment, try, fail, get back up again, try, and succeed on our own accord. In my humble opinion, I feel that AI should be kept at an arm's length or as far away as responsibly possible from the arts or any facet of raw human creativity. With any AI tool we use, we should bank in on what its creator makes it out to be and what its consumer, us, intend to use it for. Heeding to Simon Sinek's advice of starting with a why, moving on to the how and finishing with the what. AI has definitely brought us a mighty, mighty long way. But how much of that journey has helped us? how much has hurt us, and how many of us are willing to let it keep hurting us. I'll leave you with that.